then he's not gonna jump out because he
doesn't
notice the gradual heat. And that I feel like is what happened to me.
Guys, Aurora, you don't have to wash this cup. Hi, speak. Hi, welcome everybody. Can you guys tell me if I'm like standing up weird? Let me know. Because I took my phone and I, you know, I slanted it. So if I look weird to you, afternoon. Thank you for the hearts. Please share the scope also. So just let me know if I'm looking weird right now to you. If I'm like upside down. That's what I'm gonna know. Let me know if I'm upside down. Because this is my first time positioning my phone this way. Thank you for inviting your followers. Thank you. Oh, I done dropped y'all. I dropped y'all. Hi, Miss Clark. Hello. Yes. I hope I'm not upside down, guys. I hope I'm not. Thank you for sharing on Twitter. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Sharing is caring, guys. Sharing is caring. We got to support each other as women. It's just so important. Thank you so much for the hearts. So in 2 days, well, basically after tomorrow, we're going to be in June. Okay, we're going to be in June. So those of you who are Sensi consultants and your wives are watching this for on a playback. Oh, I dropped you guys again. Okay, sorry. If you guys are watching this on the playback, definitely heart it up and share it, okay? Because we got to talk really, really quick. If I drop it one more time, I swear. I swear. Okay, those of you who don't know me, my name is Leticia Campbell, and I'm a certified Sensi consultant. My website is called SenseThatInspired.Sensi.us, and today we're going to talk about doing some income-producing activities for the month of June, okay? This month, guys, we cannot get into the habit, I'm talking about for June, for getting those sales in the last minute. No, if you set yourself up properly, you'll be making your goal like your first 2 weeks of June. Okay, so that means that the first 2 weeks of June, you guys know my tips. You guys know it, Bridget, Jamie, April, all you girls know my tips. Focus on your sales the first 2 weeks, and then the 2 weeks after that, the rest of the month, you'll be focusing on recruiting and getting bookings for July. All right, I said it correctly. The first 2 weeks, focus on your sales. Focus on making your goal for that month. And then the rest of the month, you're just focusing on setting yourself up for July. Okay? So what that means is you got to do some income-producing activity for these first 2 weeks. Right now, we're practically in the first week of June. Let's say technically on that. All right? Let's just say that. Right now, you should be reaching out to people, asking them if they want you to email a catalog to them, seeing if they want to do a Facebook party with you or a basket party with you or a home party with you or whatever. Closing the loop, making sure you're closing loops with people, that you're following up with everybody and you're setting yourself up. I set myself up so far. Hi, Jamie. Hi. How are you? I set myself up right now to, I know off the bat, by June 10th, I'm going to at least have $1,300 in the bank. Okay? That's how I set myself up. And how am I going to do that? Thank you for sharing, Jamie. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Girl, and oh, Jamie, let's scale back. I want to know if Wednesday at 7 p.m. was good for us to do a Zoom chat, a live Zoom. I don't know if you got back to my email this morning. Okay, let me write that down. Okay, so I'll give you all the information and let me know. Just download the Zoom app onto your phone and you can look at it through your phone or your laptop, computer, whatever. And we're going to get into it. All right? Awesome. Yes, and any of you consultants who want to reach out to me and, you know, like I said, check out my new Facebook group on Facebook called Power Up Your Sensi Business. It's actually titled Power Up Your Business because I had to take Sensi out of it. But yeah, hi Adrian, hello, yes, welcome. So yeah, so Jamie, am I positioned weird? Because I put my phone like sideways. So I want to know if am I upside down? That's what I really want to know. Let me know if I'm upside down. Okay, good, awesome. All right, Jamie, so as I said before, Hi, thank you, Adrian. Adrian, you're a Sensi consultant. I love my first timers. Please share the scope, Adrian. How are you? Well, I love my blue hearts. I love my blue hearts. Love, love, love. Yes, blue hearts. Love them. Love them, love them, love them. Yes. So, what we were talking about, Jamie, is that setting yourself up, Donnell's scope. What about her scope? She's on now? If Donnell's on now, I will get off because I never go on when my coach is on. Oh, okay. I just think, for me, and that's just me, guys, you can do how you want. Whenever my coach is on, I never am on scope. I will wait till after or before she's on. Okay. Yes, that's what I do. I don't want to go on while the queen is on. It's just, to me, that's disrespectful. If you're a Long Islander, that's like walking on somebody's grass. That is so disrespectful. Like, if you have a house on Long Island, you would not dare walk across somebody's grass. That is like, that's disrespectful. The first time is I think she's well done. Oh, yes. Adequate and honored. Yes. It's just disrespectful. I just don't do it. Everybody else is different. But the minute somebody says, oh, Donnell's on. Okay, guys. I talk to you later. You know what I'm saying? I just think that's disrespectful. Oh, I love you, Donnell, if you're watching. Yes. Yes. So back to what I was talking about, Jamie. We're talking about setting yourself up the proper way for June. So how I do my business, thank you for sharing, Adrian. How I work my business is that the first 2 weeks of every month, I focus on my sales, my personal sales. And then the rest of the month, I focus on finding bookings, getting bookings for July and recruiting. All right, you gotta, like, it's sort of like Christina Steinberg's scalable systems, but it's like the scalable systems pertaining to the month. Those of you who have not watched Christina Steinberg's YouTube scalable systems, you need to watch it because it will save your life, it will organize your business, and it will get your stuff together. Okay, so I do that, and I sort of like migrated over to my month. All right, so first 2 weeks focus on sales, and the rest of the month focus on finding hosts and gaining recruits. Okay, so that's what I do. So, what are you going to do to get sales for the first 2 weeks? Somebody just type it and pop it up if you're a Sensi consultant. Tell me some of the things that you're going to do in the next 14 days to get some sales. Tell me.
In a marriage, to have more than one pregnancy together, it's like a new and different adventure.
Every single time.
Mary get one.
Yeah, network. How are you going to network, Jamie?
Dizziness through her pregnancy.
This is like a Q&A, so we're going to get you on some new ideas, new plans, everything. So how are you going to network your business? How are you going to network in order to get sales for your business? Contact new friends on Facebook. Yes. Contact new friends.
I'm like, April, I noticed that while you're doing that, you're
making connections,
seeking
knowledge.
Is that okay?
Yeah. No, awesome. Speak, so what is your name? I know you probably told me this before, but I'm sorry. So you want to connect with new friends, Jamie, but you also want to follow up with your old customers. If you have a customer that has not purchased from you in the past 2 months, guess what? You need to give them a call. And I meant what I say by calling them. Don't text them. Don't email them. People love, you're in the direct sell business, okay? So if you're a direct seller and your primary means of communication is texting and emailing, I don't know why you're in this business. You're in the people business. You're in direct sales. So you need to directly speak to that person. You know what I mean? So it's nothing like a phone call, guys. It's nothing like a phone call. It's nothing like that. You're hearing that person's voice and they're hearing your voice and you're asking them, you know, I noticed that you purchased the, I'm new, Etta, I love you. Oh, all right, Etta, let me write that down because I'll just forget your name, girl. It's nothing about like that personal customer service, you calling them. Hi, PJs. You contacting them, I call more as personal. Yeah, call is more personal than texting and whatever. Like if I have a customer, she loves purchasing pineapple sorbet. That is her favorite. That's all she orders. I have tried to get her into trying other fragrances along with pineapple sorbet. No, she just loves pineapple sorbet. I have a customer that loves newborn nursery. I'm unforgettable. Yes. I have a customer that loves purchasing newborn nursery. She gets it in the room spray. She gets it in the bar. She gets it in the scent circle. I mean, everything. She always contacted me, asking me, let me know when they're going to carry the newborn nursery in the detergent line. Please. And trust me, I'm going to call her the minute it happens. Yes. I'm actually going to order it off the bat and just deliver it to her house. But I have a customer that loves it. So, for example, I just had a customer. Her name is Ade. She just purchased pineapple sorbet back in March. Okay. So I'm going to contact her and I'm going to let her know, you know, hi, Ade. I'm going to put through your order for the pineapple, a three pack of the pineapple sorbet. I'm going to put it in this week. Okay. And so she's always going to say yes. And so you could do one or two things. You could order it and then deliver it to her and collect the money that way, or, you know, just refer her to her website. It's all up to you. But again, you know, another thing you could do, Jamie, is again, follow up with those old customers. It's much easier to keep an older customer than gaining new customers. You're going to find and realize that, you know. Another thing you could be doing, how many parties do you have booked this month, Jamie? Of your consultant watching this, also, I love my blue hearts. You don't have none? And that's fine. Girl, Jamie, I'm not going to beat you in the head because you don't have no party. That's fine. Make your own party. Make your own Facebook party. Make your own basket party. Once a week, like April. I never done house party. I don't do house parties. I'm sorry. I don't like people in my house. I don't even like my kids in my house. Like, I keep them in here because the Lord says I do. You know what I mean? I don't like people running through my house. Okay. So that I don't do. I know there's a lot of other consultants. There's one consultant. Yeah. This is one consultant. I forgot her name. She has like a short hair and she always has in a mohawk. I don't know. I forgot her name. But she does a lot of open house. And who else does? Katie Farner. She does. My house not big enough. Yeah, my house is not big enough either. I mean, it's big enough, but I don't want people in my house. I don't even want my family member over here. My family member knows if you don't call me before you come, I'm not opening my door. You know what I'm saying? Okay. So put something on the light bill. How about that? Okay. May is the month to experience. I'm sorry. Long story. I was traumatized as a child. I just don't like, I barely have enough. Yes. I don't like people out. So, but if you want to do an open party in your home, by all means, do it, and have fun with it. I know if I, guys, please. I know pretty much, I love the yellow hearts. I know if I did had a open house, I know that there would be a lot of people that would come. But the Lord has not blessed me with the gift of hospitality. That's just not something that I'm crafted in. I have a lot of family members who are, and I say God bless you to them all. My mother-in-law lives right down the street. She is a very hospitable person. I'm just not. But moving on, enough about me. Let's talk about you. You can do your own party. You can do your own Facebook party. You can do your own basket party. You could just, you know, you could have your own event. So just because you don't have any parties booked, that doesn't mean anything. The whole month of April, I didn't have any parties booked, and I was able to make my goal. Another thing that you could do is like what I spoke about in my last video that I did yesterday, is to go down your Facebook and see who is actively always posting. Not on your personal page. What is your goal for June? My goal for June, I don't want to say it out loud. I have it written up right here and everything, but I don't like to announce my goals. But we could talk about that when we're doing our one-on-one. Yes. So, well, let me tell you this. My goal is to make, if you know anything about me, my goal is to make, for June, is to make enough money to pay my light bill in full. My goal is to be able to, I'm working on a surprise trip for my husband. His birthday's in November, and I'm working on booking a trip to Vegas for the whole week for him. Because I did that last year and we had a lot of fun. That's my goal. So think about how much that's cost, and that's going to be my goal, and I'm going to make it. Yes. Yes. So, because whenever I say my goals, people automatically be like, oh my God, that is so much. But for me, it's not. So, I'd rather, you know what I'm saying? It sort of like trips people out because I'm such a big, huge thinker. So, when you have a big goal, you got to do big things with your business. And some people, their mindset is not really, they don't think that broad. So, sometimes you can scare people when you have somebody who has such a big, big, outlook on their business. It could scare those people who are looking into wanting to join and then think like, oh, I can't do that. But yes, you can. If you join my team, I'll show you how. You know what I'm saying? So that's why. But yes, that's my goal. So another thing, and I will send you guys the pictures, honey.
I understand.
All right. So another thing is emailing your catalogs to people, and once you email it to them, follow up. Follow up with them. You know what I did today, Jamie? Are you still there? I think you have the blue hearts. I don't know who has the blue hearts. But you know what I did today, Jamie? Oh, awesome. Today is Monday, Memorial Day. It's the 30th. And guess what I did today? I emailed the picture of the warmer and scent of the month to everybody in my contacts today. I emailed them the flyer. I emailed to them, and I explained to them because you guys know that the less travel warmer this month in May got sold out. So I want a leg up on this. I want my customers to have the opportunity to get this warmer. Yeah, it sold quick. I think that warmer sold the second week of May. If I go back and check, because I actually had to sell mine. I wasn't even able to do a video on the warmer of the month for May. Because the minute I got it in my house, I already promised it that I was going to sell it to somebody else. And I just drove it to her house and dropped it. I didn't even open the box of the warmer. I just gave it to her, and she bought that for me and 3 bars. And that was it. I wasn't even able. That's how quickly it went. So I want to like up on it. So I started sending out the flyer for the warmer of the month for June. And I told you getting another one. For May?
Anyway.
May, we can't buy any of the warmer. Hi, Ivy. No, I'm not buying. I don't think you can get the traveled warmer anymore. Once it's sold out, that's it. Hey! Once it's sold out, that's it. But what I did was today, yes, you can. I won't come till July. Oh, no. Mm-mm. That's all right. I don't like it that much. But yes. But yes. I normally sell my, whenever I get a warmer of the month, whenever I buy it, I'm intending to sell it, you know, instantly. So the only one that warmer up that I still have right now is the calligraphy warmer and this one. Hold on. And this one. This is from the holidays. And I'm not going to sell this one because I really like that one. This one. And as you like, because I keep it right up here on my desk, I really, really like this one. So those two are the only ones that I kept, but all the rest of them, I just sold. I just sell it. If they want it, I sell it. But, yeah. Huh? Yeah, that one's different, Aurora. It's my Cincy Psychic. So what I did was today, Jamie, is I emailed out the warmer that, yeah, I have to sell a few. Yeah, sell it. Sell it. I swear, because there was at one point where I had so many warmers just laying around the house. And where's my rubber? Aurora, give me a rubber band. Give me a rubber band. I'm so hot. It's so hot. Yeah. I have so many warmers. I mean, some of the warmers I'm always going to keep. I love my Bali warmer. Oh, my God. I love, love, love. Who had pink hearts? I love pink. Pink is my favorite color. Yes. So, Aurora, give me a rubber band. So, I mean, I guess so that's what I did today. And so what I'm going to do is all those people that I emailed today with the flyer of the June warmer and scent of the month. No, I need a bigger one. You don't have a bigger one? No, I don't need orange. This is fine. All the people that I emailed to the Warmer Incentive of the Month for June, I'm going to follow up with them on Wednesday. Okay? I'm going to follow with them on Wednesday, and I'm going to let them know. Yeah, please do that. I'm going to let them know, like, you know, listen, I'm going to submit my orders this week. Would you like for me to add yours? Okay? And y'all could figure out on the back end how you're going to work out the payment thing. It's really simple. Make it as convenient as possible for your customer to pay for their order.
And they really truly love each other.
So that's another way you could generate sales. Because if you have 30 emails, right? I'm going to say at least 20% of them will buy from you. 20%. Where my calculator at? Hello? I had it right here. I swear I did. Oh, here it go. Lord, forgive me. I thought my chillins then took my calculator. So, Jamie, let's say you have 30 people. On your list, right? Matter of fact, let me talk about myself. I emailed 59 people today. 59, right? Ooh, 59 minus 59. You got multiplied. Okay. Let's say 12 of them purchased the Warmer Incentive of the Month for June. And how I sell it, and you're not going against compliance by doing it, I offer to them, listen, guys, you got to get it on the Warmer, the Scent Circle, and the Bar. I try to do it in group my bundles in threes. Okay? I'm not giving them no extra discount. I'm still doing it according to the monthly special. So all three of those, that's like $38.70. So let's say 12 of them who I emailed today purchased from me. That's $464.
This questioning thing that she constantly does?
Right there. All right. So let's just say out of the 59 people I emailed today, 12 of them order for me. That's $464 right there. Okay? Yeah. So you offered it like a bundle. You know my story of where that came from, how I got that idea. And it's more convenient because you're giving your customers more and you're giving them at a discounted price. So why not offer it as like a bundle? As like, okay, they're going to get the scent circles because most of my customers drive. Buy five, get one free. You can do that if you want to. You could email them a picture of the buy five, get one free and follow up with them. You know, you could choose the fragrances for them. You could say, you know what? I'm offering a bundle this week. Buy five, get one free. You get the French lavender. You get the newborn nursery. You get the clothes liner. You get the pure blossom. You get the clean breeze. You get the Luna. Right there. You could do that if you want to. You know, however you want to do it, think of a creative idea to do it. All right? But the point is you got to get it out there and you got to share it with people. Because if you don't share it, you're not going to get anything back. If you're just sitting there waiting for you to get that email where, oh, you got a new PWS order, you're probably going to get that maybe once a month. You know what I'm saying? So that's another way. Work with what you got. Work with what you got. Work with what you got. Okay, so again, focus on income producing activities for the first 2 weeks of the month. For the first 2 weeks of the month, of this month, focus on income producing activities. So by the 10th of this month, you should be at the majority of your goal. Like you said, Jamie, your goal is to make $500. You should be at $500 by the 10th of this month. If every day, if you're doing income producing activities, you should be at $500 easy. Easy. Okay? What is that? What is that noise? Oh my God. Yes, I tried to get my sales in the beginning. Yeah, try to get your sales in the beginning, then waiting to the end of the month. All right? Try to get them in the beginning of the month. Now, I'm just talking about promoting the June Warmer of the Month. You could promote other things too on top of that. those people that you send out catalogs to, you need to also follow with them. So that's another stream of income for your business. All right. And again, you can do all this, Jamie, going off having no bookings this month. All right. You're going to have to work harder this month. Just know that. You know what I'm saying? And even sometimes when you do have bookings, they could flop. Like I remember back in November, I had 7 pouch parties that I sent out and all of them flopped. You're welcome. All of them flopped. Like they just, bleh. Okay. I don't know. I did hosting, coaching. I did everything. But the whole point is that you can't control people. You can only control yourself. So if you're doing what you can do, everything possible for your business, if you go out there, you're hustling, you're promoting the warm of the month, you're promoting the combine and save, you're just out there hustling, you're going to make your goal. So I have a home party booked for the 25th. And for me, that home party is just going to be an add-on on top of my goal, right on top of it. So I'm planning to make more than what my projected goal is for this month, because I'm already going to have my goal in by the 10th. Because I'm going to work my butt off today, this whole entire week, and the whole entire next week. I'm going to be busy. Okay? And Jamie, let me know if you have any questions. Yes, I'm going to hustle big time. This month might change my goal. Yeah, you can. You can adjust it. Because, if you think you can make 1,000 in PRV this month, thank you for the hearts. Do it. But remember what we spoke about on Sunday, Jamie. It's all about your mindset. It's all about your mindset. Come up with a number, and then under that number, you're going to write down how you're going to make it. What you're going to do to make it. And it all depends on you. It all depends on you. Yes, mindset. It's everything. It's everything. Mindset is everything. Trust me. The minute you change your mind, you change your whole entire world. Your whole entire world changes. And I tell my kids that every single day. And I know you do too, Jamie. I know you tell your kids that you can do anything you put your mind to. Anything. You want to be the president of the United States. If you want to be an astronaut. If you want to be anything. As long as you set your mind, you can do it. So, Jamie, what you and I need to do is really back up our words and really be mindsetters. And whatever we set our mind to, we do it. So when our kids get older, they have no excuse. What are they going to say? Because if mommy did it, you can do it. I bust my butt. I hustled. I did everything I can do. So it's nothing you can say. Let my kids come at me sideways talking about mommy, I can't do it. Child, I will. Oh, they'll be. Oh, they won't be able to get the kick. They won't be able to get the in out before I'm done with them. Okay. Let them come at me like that. Because I'm ready. I'm ready. Okay. Let them. So it's a mindset. If you change your whole mindset, you change your whole entire world. Change your mindset about June, Jamie. Change it. What level are you at? You at certified?
It's not personal
in any way. It's solid. Jamie, in June, we're going to be lead. In June, if you're willing to hold my hand and I'm holding yours, we're going to make lead this month. We're going to make lead. And I already wrote it down. Already wrote it down. Bam. Put it on paper. Yeah. We're going to make it. Because we're planning now. The both of us. No, B-O-F. You know that. Both. That's our word. The both of us. Okay? Because we're playing. Yes, thank you. We're playing it now. It ain't even June yet. So now we're sitting down and you and I are having a business meeting with ourselves. And those of you who are watching this on the replay, have a business meeting with yourself and come up with a goal and then come up with an action plan to make that goal. And it all depends on you. Don't blame it on, oh, my hostess canceled on me. Don't blame it on, oh, my God, nobody responded to my email. Don't blame it on nothing. If people are not responding, you need to go out there and get them. You need to go out there and get them. Seriously, I'm not a Jehovah's Witness, but I have a lot of respect for the Jehovah's Witness. I do. I would never be a Jehovah's Witness. I love being a Christian. That's just what it is. But I got a lot of respect for them. no matter what, I have a group of these Jehovah's Witnesses. They're always knocking on everybody's door. They do whatever, people slam the door in their face. They tell them to go away. They put signs up. Woo! I done dropped y'all. They do all that. But they just keep coming. They keep coming. They don't let that stop them because they have a mission.
Trust issues.
And that's how you need to have. Yes, some people can be so, yeah, but they still have a mission.
I don't know.
And they still go out there and execute that. And that's how we need to be as consultants. We need to have a mission. They are so committed. Yeah, and they commit. You have a mission, you got to be committed to your mission. Yes. Let me write that down. Woo! Mission, be committed. Yes. You have a mission and be committed to your mission. So get out there, Jamie, whoever are the consultants who are watching this, come up with a plan, come up with a mission, and be committed to your mission. Be committed to your plan. Be committed. If you have people out there that are negative, don't share your mission with them. Don't.
Doubts.
Keep that to yourself. If they ask you, oh, what's going on with your business? It's going great. Thank you. It's going great. Thank you. Don't share it with everyone. Some people you can't share it with. You know what I mean? So focus on your mission and be committed to your mission. All right? Was this helpful to you guys? I really would like to know. Just resetting, those of you who don't know me, my name is Leticia Campbell, and I'm a certified Sensi consultant, and my website is called sensethatinspire.sensi.us. Yes, I have a website, girl, sensethatinspire.sensi.us. If you, like, tap up, you could click on it. Yes. Yes, and that's what I tell my, you know, that's what I tell my team, you know, make a goal and act on it. And change your mindset. Change your mindset. Right now, it hasn't even... Thank you. PJs, what's your name?
I still have, like, some insecurities and question marks and all these things going on in my head. And so that's why when Robin and Cody just say...
So when we meet, Jamie, on Wednesday at 7 p.m., are you in Eastern Standard Time or Central, or what's your time zone?
It's 100%.
Thank you for the yellow heart.
It's not personal. You know I trust you. Brianna's not with you before. I mean, in fact, do you want to have Brianna?
Oh, you're in New York too. That yes, I'm not a current rep in direct sales, but I know its skills are priceless. Thanks for sharing.
Brianna
yes.
Indoors, Mary, and she
yes.
loves
yeah.
And she has gone on trips with her before. And so I was like, you know.
Thank you. PJs, what's your name again? I'm sorry. The thing about it is that, like I said on Sunday, like I used to work in retail management. So a lot of the skills, and I had a whole team. I started out with a team of 12, and then I eventually had a team of like over 30 people that I was held accountable for. And I had like 6-7 different stores that I ran. So a lot of the skills, Jeanette.
This isn't anything personal. This isn't about... That I don't trust
Simmons.
You.
Thank you, Jeanette.
Trust you.
A lot of the skills that I applied to my business now is what I learned from working in retail. And I have a degree, guys. You know what I mean? But it's nothing like experience. You know what I mean? It's nothing like learning how to manage people, learning how to adjust to sales goals when you're not having a good week and learning how to adjust people. And learning how to deal with people who are just negative. Like, oh, even on my team, you know, you're going to have those couple of girls that are just like, oh, my God, nobody, most people don't use their degree anyway. Yeah, I'm in marketing herbal supplement. Oh, awesome. You know, you got those team members that think, oh, nobody wants to buy from me, but they haven't posted anything since the Bring Back My Bar. Oh, you look so cute. Yeah. Mommy's almost done. Love the blue hearts. So I apply a lot of what I learned, a lot of my experience to that. Let's see him. Come here, Warren. Girl, you're going to laugh, Jamie. Come here.
It really does come down to...
Warren, he can walk on his own. Let him walk. Wait till you see him, girl. You're going to pass out. Yeah. I'm about to call you Jamie. Warren... No, come on this side. Come on this side. Come on this side. Come on. Come here.
Wait
till you see him. Look at him. Y'all see he has socks on his hands. He is a hot. Look at his socks. Yes. I swear he's a hot mess. He's a hot mess. He'll change like 5 times a day. He's a hot mess. Everybody thinks he's a girl. It's so funny. Every time we go, I'm like, oh, she's so cute. I'm like, he's a boy. He's having fun. That's all that matters. That's why I like having a lot of kids, because they entertain themselves. I look at people who have one child and I'd be like, you need to have more kids. Not right now, bub. Because they entertain themselves. They entertain. Back up. Oh, you done dropped Warren. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I want one more, which is in production. Oh, I done dropped y'all again. I'm so sorry. Yeah, then you can have one. But not right now. It's okay. They went bye-bye. I plan on having one more. I always wanted 4. So, you think you're done? I don't know. I said I would be done with 2, but after I had my second one, God didn't tell me to stop. So, the minute the Lord says stop, I'll stop. But I want to have much as I can. Yeah, the only one, 2. Yeah, I only wanted 2 and ended up with 3, and then thinking about having, then I had, you had to, oh God, I don't want twins. I don't want twins. I like to have one at a time, but if I get twins, that's awesome. Ooh, you okay? Oh, sorry. Ooh. Yeah. So I'm going to head off. I got to clean up this house. I literally cleaned it like 3 times, and the minute I turn around, it's a mess. And I hope, guys, especially for those of you who are watching the replay, that this was helpful. This month, yes, I have to go. Yes. So for the next 2 weeks, focus on doing income-producing activity. If it's not income-producing activity, wait to do it towards the end of the month. Okay? Do not do anything that's not income-producing activity. That's all you should be focusing on. If you get someone who's interested, yeah, respond to that. But if you, for example, if you have team members, yes, if you have team members that are not really doing anything with their business, you know, and they'll send you like an email or something, but and then you have right after that a customer who's interested in buying, answer the customer's email first and then get to the recruit that's not doing that much with their business. I mean, that's how I do it, you know. But again, income producing activity for the next 2 weeks, that's all you need to be focusing on. That's what needs to be the majority of your time. Thank you, Jamie. Thank you. You guys continue to enjoy your Memorial Day. I'm not doing anything today because it's raining and I'm not going out. It's not going to happen. So I'm going to boil. We're not going outside. Y'all see the rain? Hello? Do y'all see the rain? No. Yeah, it's raining where I'm at. It's like rain. Yeah, no. It's raining like on and off. But it's not like. No, I'm not going out. Yeah. We're going to make some hot dogs. We're going to put some hamburgers. We got this. Hi, Bridget. Hey. Welcome. Did you catch my last video, Bridget? Yesterday? Did it give you life? Yeah. Did it give you life, girl? And I added you to my group. I hope you saw it. Yes. I'm glad you did. Jamie's here too. Jamie said hi. Bridget is in the building. And Bridget, I caught your replay. I think I gave you like 4. Oh, thank you! And the video you did on recruiting, I'm not recruiting, on. The video you did talking about Facebook friends. Bye, Jamie. I shared that with my team and they loved it. They loved it. At first, when I added it to my team page, it wasn't working, but then I downloaded it and stuff. But it worked. But that was some powerful advice, girl. That was some power. I had to give you like almost 2,000 hearts on that one. It was really, 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 really good. really good. Even the trolls that came in, you was just shutting them down. You know what I'm saying? Yes. Yes, I had to. I had to. Yes, so you're going to have to catch the replay for this one too, because basically, no, I don't want to wear that. Basically, what I was talking about was doing income-producing activities for the next 2 weeks, doing things that is income-producing for your business, and then the rest of the month, focus on hosting and recruiting. I'm going to sit down and make it a little, make it a little better. Make one a little better.
I know she loves me.
I love it.
She doesn't.
It was good the way it is, you know?
Weird.
Yeah, go ahead. It was good the way it is, in my opinion. But if you want to change it up, go ahead. It's up to you, doll. Yeah. It's up to you. So I'm going to head out. Yes, I got to, because we ain't going outside today. I'm not doing no grilling. I know you said, Bridget, you ain't doing no grilling today. My weekend was good. I was hustling with my business. You know, I was hustling. I was closing the loop. You know, I always talk about that, closing the loop. We had Chick-fil-A. Oh, okay. I never had Chick-fil-A before. But I was hustling. All weekend, I was hustling, working my business. And that's what I'm doing today, too. So, yeah. It is? I never had Chick-fil-A, ever. So, Bridget, I'm going to catch you next time. Thank you so much for coming on and joining my scope. Thank you, dog. Good. I'm closing up some things tonight. Yes. Yes, I work to the end. I work to the 11:59 tomorrow. I'm going to work my business. Getting those last few stragglers. Okay. Thanks for the hearts, Bridget. Thanks. Bye, love.